thank you so much, Anne-Marie, for your nice introduction and for your remarkable effort in making this wonderful event possible. And good morning, everyone. And it's my great pleasure and honor to introduce our distinguished keynote speaker today, Dr. Lawson Brogan. Dr. Brogan is a world-renowned interdisciplinary scholar in Arctic studies and policy. And he is a distinguished professor of geography and Arctic policy at the University of Alaska, Fairbanks. He's also a senior fellow at the Institute of the North in Anchorage. And he's also a fellow for the Center for Arctic Study and Policy at the U.S. Coast Guard Academy, where he received his bachelor's degree. He then received his master's and PhD from the University of Cambridge. He is an international leader in many important issues, such as power climate change and marine transportation, marine policy and ocean security, satellite remote sensing of sea ice, and power environment management and sustainable use, and power geopolitics. For example, he was chair of the Arctic Council's Arctic Marine Shipping Assessment, which produced a really influential report. And he was also instrumental in the development of the International Maritime Organization's Power Code, which seeks to promote maritime safety and environmental sustainability in the Arctic water. Dr. Brogan is was a career U.S. Coast Guard officer, sailing from 1975 to 1999, over 4 centuries, and he retired with the rank of captain. He served at sea in command of 4 Coast Guard cutters, including Great Lake Iceberg, which is in the back of the here, and also a polar iceberg. He has participated in more than 15 Arctic and Antarctic expeditions. He also spent 2 years in commanding the largest ship in the U.S. Coast Guard on Arctic and Antarctic expeditions. Furthermore, he has served as Chief of Strategic Planning in Washington, D.C. I can go on and on to talk about his numerous other remarkable achievements, but I'm going to share something that about his connection with MSU. He has long-term connection friendship with the MSU faculty members, like Fritz Nelson mentioned last night. He also made a known Governor Blanchard for a long time, and also visited MSU Law School for a meeting, gave a talk here a couple years ago. So I had the good fortune to meet with him last year during a meeting on the Arctic organized by U.S. Coast Guard. So surprisingly, when I received the invitation, I thought there was a mistake because I never done research in the Arctic before. And actually, I have not collaborated and did not even know anybody in the U.S. Coast Guard, to be honest with you. And I only did some research in other parts of the world. And in connection with the Arctic, I was invited to give a keynote in an international conference in Alaska, which is not about the Arctic alone. And I did serve on the advisory board of the University of Alaska for a large NSF project. But that does not qualify for me to participate in the meeting on the Arctic. But later on, I found out the U.S. Coast Guard was interested in what my colleagues and I have been doing on top of the human natural systems approach, and which is to integrate human systems with the natural systems. And traditionally, as many of you know, people have been trying to separate them. And social scientists to work on the human issues, and the ecologists to work on the environment issues, and so on. So we have been trying to integrate them. That's the name of our center, Systems Integration and Sustainability. By systems integration, we mean we can integrate everything, including integrating across different disciplines and across the space, including those places far away and nearby, and also over time. And U.S. Coast Guard is very interested in a lot of issues, including climate change and the whole climate change may affect the Arctic, particularly how Bering Strait between Alaska and Russia will become a even more important transportation route. So they are interested, I think, particularly in a new framework called the telecoupling. Telecoupling means social, economic, and environment interactions over distance. And telecoupling distance, and coupling in the human environment interactions. And this framework would be useful to understand, help understand the new global connection that Dr. Bergam had been working on this for many years, and he's going to talk about this this morning. And during the U.S. Coast Guard organized meeting, I was very impressed with his presentation. And after his presentation, I chatted with him, and then we had a great chemistry, and instantly. So we agreed to continue to communicate. So after my return to MSU from the U.S. Coast Guard meeting, I shared the information with my new PhD student, Kelly Kupser. She is remarkable, a university distinguished fellow. And some of you may know that I have been doing research with my student collaborator for the last 2 decades on pandas, people, and policy in China. But pandas are now recovering and actually have been delisted from the endangered species. Now we have some extra time so that we want to apply the lessons and experience that we learned from our previous research to other places, including the Arctic. So Kelly has been very interested in applying the telecoupling framework to the Arctic. So she said, can she contact Dr. Bergam? I said, of course. You know? She took the initiative to contact Lawson, and Lawson had been very generous in helping her develop her doctoral research. So during one of the meetings that Anne Mary organized, so Kelly and I mentioned the idea to invite Lawson to campus. And Anne Mary immediately agreed, and she has done a wonderful job in organizing this trip. And we are so thrilled that Lawson is here this week with us, and his visit will help MSU further advance the Arctic research and here and beyond. And Lawson has accomplished so much, so I want to also mention that he wants to do more to the scientific society and to the society in general. And one thing he's doing now, he's running for the president, next president of the U.S. No, but running for the president of a very prestigious scientific organization called Sigma Xi, which is a scientific honor society, one of the oldest and largest scientific societies. And based on his track record, and there is no question that he will do absolutely amazing job for the society as the president. So I have renewed my membership and voted for him. And so I will encourage you to renew your membership and join the society and vote for him. And before disabled. So without further ado, let's welcome Dr. Lawson Bergam to give